Good evening. Welcome to Epiphany Lutheran Church in Richmond, Virginia. I'm Kevin Barger, the Director of Music Ministry. This is our Music Minute. We welcome you tonight as we take a look at the hymns we'll be using in worship tomorrow, the third Sunday after Epiphany. And this will be the gathering hymn, Dearest Jesus, at Your Word. And this is another of those Catherine Winkworth translations we've talked about. She's the translator extraordinaire who have taken all those hymns from their original language in German and so forth and put them into English for us. The last stanza of this hymn actually seems to be have added later as a doxology. And the tune was first published actually more as a solo piece. So it was really like a soloist would sing it as opposed to a congregational. It didn't take its congregational form until several years later. The tune, the author of the tune, was a church musician, but he was also the mayor of the town where he lived, and he went to the University of Erfurt. So this is Dearest Jesus, at Your Word. Recognize that. We'll move to a more modern day hymn, and this would be Christ Be Our Light, and that is going to be our sending hymn tomorrow. The stanzas of this have a pretty unique wording that they show us some longing for the signs of the kingdom of God, and we want those signs to come to us as servants of the church. The refrain is a petition, another longing, if you will. And in there, we see that we're asking that Christ be our light and shine in our hearts as the church is gathered by that light that we are hoping Christ will be. Christ be our light.
Thank you.
That's sort of a tricky one. Every time you think you hear the melody and it's going to go somewhere, it goes somewhere different. But that's that Christ light that is all over, and hopefully gave you that sense of it being all around and over and about. Next, we will go to a new one from All Creation Sing. This is God's Work, Our Hands. And this particular hymn is a result of the ELCA, the Evangelical Lutheran Church in America, held a contest in 2019, and they were looking for a new hymn to be used for God's Work, Our Hands Sunday, which we typically do right around Rally Day, if not on Rally Day. And this actually was first premiered, and this particular hymn was written by Wayne Wald and premiered in 2019 on September 13th. And it was the winning hymn. He developed a denomination or a Lutheran tagline with other parts of the person that God uses. So when you see the words tomorrow, you'll understand. So it talks about the entire body. It lists concrete ways that God is manifest in the presence of the world. And it also is confessing God's activity beyond the church's work, beyond these four walls, and inviting blessing on that work on behalf of the gospel. So this is God's Work, Our Hands. It is sung to the tune of Earth and All Stars, which I think you'll probably recognize. This is another one of those pieces, variations of it, that you'll get little snippets of it, and then it goes off into somewhere else. So you might have to listen a little bit harder.
Thank you.
the melody out? Hopefully you did. All right, last but not least is the communion hymn, which will be I Love to Tell the Story. And this was written as part of a poem in 1866. And the author was writing it as she was weak and weary after an illness. So that's sort of where that comes from. This is a bit of a controversial hymn, as I mentioned before. Some regard the poetry as being written in an accessible or helpful way to relate to things. Others don't see it that way, and they might see it that it's that they're saying it trivializes the Christian story into a nursery rhyme, is how some have described it. It's, however, whatever you think, it is clear that the author had genuine evangelical missionary outlook as she was writing this, and you can sense that in the fervor, and it serves as a witness to Christ and the story. And that's where it appears in ELW, is in the witness section. So definitely is as strong on that front. This is I Love to Tell the Story. So sing out loud and proud tomorrow during communion on that. So we thank you for joining us tonight. We look forward to seeing you again next week. If you're joining us for worship tomorrow, that will be at 8:30 and 11 in the sanctuary. And the 11 o'clock service, of course, is live streamed on our YouTube channel. Thanks again for joining. Have a great evening.